Hello, student. Welcome back. And today we are going to continue our lesson, chapter 7, energy and power. So just now I just scroll through this this chapter. Then we got formula to calculate kinetic, formula to calculate the work, formula to calculate the power, and so on. So then we got formula to calculate gravity, mgh, formula to calculate potential energy. Oh my gosh. And for this one, because last time we learned at form 5 physics class, you know, and now I'm seeing this at form 3 class, and I think it will be not easy lah. It will be very difficult because the government changed the syllabus, but I think the government is following like UK, so the question also become harder. It's a common thing as the generation go, things to learn is getting more difficult. Okay, so this one form 3 you learn, maybe next time form 3, form 2, form 1, then go to standard 6, because I don't know why as time passed by, the thing is getting more and more difficult. So you need to work hard lah, buy exercise and do this more mathematic. So you need to buy exercise and do rather than read. This chapter don't read too much. This one you need to learn a lot of calculation. Okay, very fast. Just go through this one. A monkey is 15 newton, point up 3 meter in 20 seconds. If you use your brain to count, you know that 50 times 3 divided by 20. 50 times 3 is to get the work done. After get work done divided by the time, 20, so you got 7.5 watt. Okay, I don't need to explain this one. I think you know, right? If you don't understand, then you look at the previous video, okay? Because previous video we already cover the formula for work and formula for power. So for this question again, blah blah blah, 30 newton, 2 meter, 5 second. First thing I need to do, I need to count the work done. Blah 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 blah. I get work done equals to 20 joule. Then I get the power, 60 joule divided by the time, so I get 12 watt. And this one, 450 newton lifted in 1 meter in 0.5. So I need to find the work first. So the work equals to 150 times 1 meter, and the time will be 0.5 divided by 0.5. I will get 300 newton. Can or not? This one you link to previous video one. If you don't understand, you can look at the previous video. And okay, let's look at this experiment. What this experiment want to do, to calculate the power needed. So this is very simple experiment. You want to do one experiment to calculate the power or the work. The work is easier to calculate lah. The power is more difficult because you need to count the time. Let's talk about work first. Okay, I don't need to read this thing, but you need to understand. Okay, you need to understand the formula for work equals to force time displacement. Still remember? And displacement is newton. Force is newton. Displacement is meter. So let's say I want to do the experiment very easy. Okay, I just take the block, I take this thing, pull. Let's say this thing is 20 newton. I know it's 20 newton. And in order to make it easy, I will make this 1 meter. So you 1 meter times 20, easy lah. You can make 1.5, 2 meter, up to you, okay? So after that, I do, I can get the work, up to you lah. We need to think like science people, okay? What you want to do. I can do maybe first one I try 1 meter, second one I try 1.5, the third one I put 2 meter. So I do the table, 1.5 meter, 1 meter, 2 meter, 2.5 meter, up to you. Then I can calculate the force. The force usually is the same. So let's say the force is 20 newton, 20 newton, 20 newton, 20 newton, and then I will get the this one times this one. I get the work. So I get 20 times 1 is 20 joule, and then this one is 30 joule. Is it 30 joule, 40 joule, and 50 joule? Something like that. Like you need to think like science, so I know that if I the longer distance, it will need more force. Okay, the higher the displacement, the higher the force needed is for the higher dis. Hey, what is this? This is the Newton, and this one need to write properly. If not, also I confused. This one is the distance, displacement, distance, and this one is the work. Yeah, if I write properly, then I can say according to the table. So the higher distance that the wooden go, the more work is done. For example, and then you want to calculate the power needed. Maybe I just need to use the clock and divide it by the time. So let's say here I put up to you lah. Let's say I do the experiment. Here is 10 seconds, 20 seconds, 30 seconds. Let's say lah, 30.5, 35.6, something like that. Then I divide it, I get the answer. Then I get the power. You get what I mean or not? I write a bit messy lah, but this is the experiment science. Means when we want to do experiment, we need to understand, we need to think, okay? Something like this. 大概我们要懂 agak-agak, we know that something like this that we want to do. Then we can answer the question. If you don't know what the question, like when you look this picture, all your here is question mark means you cannot do. Look at the picture, understand the hypothesis, and then you need to imagine if you are the scientist, what you want to do. Okay, like this. Agak-agak lah. You agak-agak, imagine your brain, something like this. I get this one. Oh my gosh. I get this one. Then what is the conclusion? You need to play in your brain lah. Then we can answer the question easier. Okay, so I no need to read because we know that I didn't read lah, but I think it's something like that lah. He repeat the experiment using the weight. Okay, put on the floor and 0.5 meter and spring balance to get the Newton, roughly like that. Okay, so activity pulling 1 meter. Yeah, this one also I didn't do experiment. I don't know which one is higher. Okay, let's say I don't know lah. I just in case lah. I think we pull up will use more energy. Okay, so pulling wooden block force. So pulling up will be 100 gram, 1 newton, so 1 kg, 0.1 kg equals to 1 newton. So this one is 1 newton. Agak-agak, this one you need to do experiment lah. Let's say this one is lesser 0.5 newton. Distance is 1 meter. Here they put 0.5, but I change to 1 meter, easier to count. Let's say the question say 1 meter. Let's say the question 1 meter because I want to make it easier. Okay, so the work done equals to force times distance. So I get 0.5, I get 1. Time, let's say I put 10 seconds, 10 seconds. So 0.5 divided by 10 is 10 seconds. Sorry, 10 seconds. So power 0.5 divided by 10 is 20, right? Is it 20? 0.5 divided by 10. 0.05. So here will be 0.05 watt, and here will be 0.1 watt. For example, so we know that by through the experiment, we know that to carry thing go up is more difficult than pulling the thing. So this one you need to do experiment, okay? State the type of force to overcome when pulling the wooden block on the surface. So what are the force that you need to overcome? This is called the friction force or drag force. Some people say friction, so I would say it's the friction force, okay? Because when you pull up, the thing will go behind, ma. So you need to overcome the friction force. Lifting 100 grams from the floor, what force you need to overcome? The gravity force, correct or not? Because we want to pull this thing up, so you need to overcome the gravity force. Which activity involve more work? This one I do one, so I'm not sure. If this one is higher, so I would say that activity lifting up the weight. It depends on the experiment. Don't say, oh, did you say this, but then you're wrong. Because I didn't do the experiment, okay? I just write it, okay? So if it's higher, then you say, which activity involve more work? We'll say is the, this one, okay? Lifting weight, for example, lifting 100 weight. I just put activity A and B lah. I don't want to write the whole thing, okay? Activity B. Assuming that when I do the experiment, I can like write my, okay, A, B activity, repeat A, B, you write here first lah. If they ask you to write my, so you write here. So I know it's activity B that use more energy and more power. In terms of energy, energy also not same, because this also use more energy. Which state three factor that affecting power? What are the three factor that affecting power? Okay, so this one I want you to try to do and think, and I want you to think. Now I give you 1 minute, later I will ask you. Okay, to those that got the answer, congratulations. The answer is in the formula. Factor that affecting the power is according to the formula. We have time. We have displacement. And one more is what? Time, displacement, and the force. Yeah. Because in order to calculate power, at least you need to have these three things. Then you can calculate the power. If you don't have this one of it, then you cannot calculate the power. Or maybe time and energy if you want. But he said three, ma. So obviously it's these three already. Which activity carry out with higher power? Okay, we already do. It's the activity B. Give one example that involve high power. Very good. Okay, so one of my students say is a refrigerator and stapler. Can up to you. I think stapler and refrigerator can, because stapler we use a lot of electric, so we use high watt, which actually means high power lah, okay? So you can put refrigerator and stapler. Which is getting less power? Up to you, okay? For me, I would, because here the experiment say about time displacement force ma. Maybe I use lorry la. I use lorry. Lorry needs to use more force displacement at the time. And then less, maybe I use carry clothes, for example. Carry bag, for example. A lot of answer la, refrigerator, lorry, car, Ferrari, don't say Ferrari la, okay? The machine to carry the thing and so on. Okay, and staple less energy, because we know when we press, obviously the force that you need to press is very low. State the definition of work. So the answer is at page 210 at your book. We can see that Work is the defined as the product. Product means time, ah. So you just remember the formula, product of force and displacement. So that will be the definition. Moving on, what is the SI unit for work? What is the SI unit for work? Still remember or not? The unit is joule. J-O-U-L-E. What is the meaning of energy? Okay, energy means the ability to do work. Okay, and state the definition of power. So what is power? Power formula is, okay, so energy, just now we do, energy is defined as the ability to do work. And power is defined as the rate of doing work. See how fast you want to finish the work. Okay, so here is the answer lah. Power equals to define is defined as the rate of doing work, means how fast you want to complete the work. Figure 1 show electromagnetic crane lifting this one and this one. Okay, so this one you can try to do. I encourage you to try to do, and you can pause this video and try to do. Okay, so the answer is 10,000 joule and 138.89 watt for C. So hopefully you guys can do, and very fast now we just go through this question. I recommend when doing this question, always remember to first write the formula, final answer, write the unit. Usually students lose mark because they didn't write the unit. When your answer is 10, it could be 10 ringgit, 10 joule, 10 kg, so you didn't write unit, then the teacher give you wrong, like mathematics lah, you didn't write the unit lah, so the teacher give you wrong. Okay, so for me, I like to write the formula. Yes, like mathematics lah, you write the formula, because I know you all very clever, you use your brain, then no write the formula, then you don't get. For form 3, not so strict lah, but for form 5, get more strict. So it's good to make a good habit to write the formula. So usually I will do like, calculate the work done, I will just write work formula equals to work equals to what? Equals to force time distance. Okay, I prefer to write in word, then I like to like put the unit lah, so I know then I won't do mistake usually. Every time you do, you just write like this first, okay, in your school, because I feel it's better lah, in later you confuse, then 1 kilometer also you put here one, okay. So force equals to 2500, this one up to you want to put your unit, you want to put up to you. This one is force, so you get 10,000 joule. Okay, how much energy is calculated to take the load? Same lah, 10,000 joule lah. Okay, so 10,000 joule, because this one the work means the energy lah. Okay, work equals the energy. Okay, so maybe you want to write, okay, work done equals to the energy. Okay, and for C, write like this in your exam, power, because I scared you guys confused, and I think it's better, then you will remember. Okay, power equals to work done divided by time, then you write the unit. Okay, power for W, work is J, and time is S. So work is, we already get 10,000 joule divided by the time is 1.2 minute. So 1.2 times 60, because it's second, so I get 72 second. So you 10,000 divided by 72, I get 138.89. And you, that is also wrong, because student forget to put W for the watt. So always like, what the student mistake is always the formula. Student didn't write the formula, and the mistake is the unit. Usually student get the answer, it's just they forget to write the unit, and you no mark lor. You know, write the unit means no mark. Okay, potential energy and kinetic energy. Okay, now we are going to learn the different formula, potential energy and kinetic energy. So little bit will change here and there, you know, kinetic to potential to electric to what can change, energy can be changed, right? Okay, so this one is called the what, power driver. Okay, so tong 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 to make the house, is it? I don't know this thing make earthquake or not lah. Last time I hear people say because this thing like make earthquake ah, a lot of people tong 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 inside the earth, and then I don't know lah, make the earth spoil or what, I don't know. But I don't think so lah. This can make earthquake one meh? Hammer being dropped, hammer after being dropped. Okay, so he tong 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 tong, then the thing go down already lah. Okay, very high tech oh. I really like this thing yeah. So what energy he want to use? Again, he want to use potential energy, gravitational potential energy. Okay, so the formula is mgh. So let me think of a formula to write. So maybe I will write GPE GPE, you can write your the name lah. GPE equals to MGH. This one is the formula because it's too long lah. So you just write MGH. And GPE equals MGH. The unit is J. When you do your exam, I just do like that. Okay. M is the mass. You put kg. Okay. G is the gravity. And H is the height is meter. Okay, so you don't confuse like you know what is okay, kg, this is the gravity. Gravity is not g. Yeah, gravity is g, not force. It's kg, it's not g, it's kg. Wait, let me take my eraser. Okay, gravity is n kg negative 1. Okay, but you just remember like this should be enough. Okay, imagine like this. Okay, GEE equals to mgh. So let's see, the crane is, let's say he pull this thing go up lah. This thing is weight 2 ton, for example, 2 ton. 2 ton means 2000 kg. So the gravitational energy equals to 2000 kg times the gravity is 10. Yeah, we know it's always 10. Times the height. So let's say the height is I put here maybe 6 meter, 10 meter lah. Let's say I put 10 meter because this thing go up mah. This thing go up, go up, go up, go up, go up, tong like that, right? So let's say I put 10 meter. So let's calculate 2000 times 10 times 10. I get 2000000 joule. So 200,000 joule. Okay. So one time is 200,000 joule, and then tong the second time plus 2000, tong one third time 200,000. So see how many time lah. Okay. So maybe if you do finish is maybe the tong for very long, right? They hit it for like 1 hour, maybe need to hit 1,000 time. So after finish, let's say he hit 1,000 time, you need to times 1,000. So you get don't know how many million mega kilojoule energy. Which you do this thing, of course you use a lot of energy. Roughly we also can calculate, okay? 200,000 times 1,000, you will get like how many million of joule energy that you already use. Okay, and relation between work and gravitational potential energy, same thing, W equals to mgh. So this one don't need lah, this one just skip. Wait, I look for the question. I see they got convert or not. Okay, and example. Okay, let's say this one is the example that the exam give. Okay, they give the lift can carry 1.5 ton, the height is 30 meter. How much work according to the formula? You need to use MGH, okay? Because it give you the height and the force, okay? MGH. So basically, you got you do. You get 450,000. Okay, basically M is 1,500 times G, gravity is 10. So time gravity is 10, and then times the MGH, mah, H the height is 30. So you get 450,000. Gravitational potential energy same lah, huh? Same. When you talk about the energy, it's always the same lah, same thing lah. You get what I mean or not? Same lah. Huh? You are also asking the same thing. I also don't know why they ask this thing. Okay, work done by the lift, gravitational potential energy of the lift, and calculate the power. So how to calculate the power? Again, we already learned. I prefer when doing in exam. Up to you lah, because I scared you guys confused, because we learned that I just write like this lah, power equals to work divided by time W N J time is S, then work equals to 450,000 divided by the time, which is 0.5 minute is 30 second. So you do, you get 15,000 watt. Okay, so this one is correct. You can write the unit W can already. If you want to write this one also can, up to you. Okay, but usually I you like, as long as